Welcome back to Fourth and Paint, the only pro wrestling show hosted by an NFL player and a weight loss champion, Redskins defensive end Adam Carriker on my left.
You now have permission to worship us.
Somebody has an ego. Former wrestling announcer, weight loss champion Chuck Carroll here.
You don't watch TNA, man?
I do.
Okay. All right.
This is Fourth and Paint, and Adam, very excited now. We have on a teammate of yours, our first ever Fourth and Paint champion, as a matter of fact, wide receiver Pierre Garcon. Pierre, thanks for joining us, man.
No problem, man. Glad to be on the show.
I got a question right out the gate. How long is it going to take before you get that belt back?
I'm thinking week one.
I love to hear that.
You ready?
Monday night,
too. You ready to get back out there?
Here's my other question. I'm healthy this year. How are you going to get it if I get it?
That's a good thing. That's a good thing. If everybody's healthy and there's a big battle for the belt.
All right.
People forget I'm in the battle this year. Watch out, folks.
Hold on. You are ineligible for that belt, man.
What?
Dude, you can't take your own belt because I'm awesome.
You're going to make the decision each week.
Fine. And I'm already deciding you're not going to win the belt.
I hate you.
Pierre Garcon joined us here on Fourth and Paint. And it was just a few weeks ago, Pierre, that you joined Adam and I at Monday Night Raw at the Verizon Center. And that was your first wrestling experience, man. How was that for you?
It was great, man. I'm glad I got to go. It was an exciting atmosphere. Everybody was involved. The fans were involved. It was great to see it from a different point of view from seeing it on TV. I saw all the posters. I enjoyed that. They interacted with the fans and, you know, made the fans feel special, and it was a great environment seeing the wrestling up and close and personal, and thanks for the great feed. I was practically in the ring, you know. It was a great thing to see all those guys in person, seeing The Rock, seeing those guys, Triple H, and all those guys do that I seen back then when I used to watch wrestling, but it was an amazing experience.
Yeah, well, don't thank us. Thank WWE.
Absolutely.
They were nice enough to put us right behind the announce table. That was pretty cool. That was great for me. I had never even done that.
I'd never been that close either. Being that close, my question is this. Looking at all the WWE superstars, you mentioned Triple H, you mentioned The Rock. Which guy was the most physically impressive to you?
Physically impressive was probably The Rock, but it was cool to see Shawn Michaels. You know, he's been a legend. And he's been doing it for a long time. And it was also cool to see The Rock. You know, he's probably one of the most popular guys. And seeing The Undertaker and all those guys were physically, The Rock probably was the one that most, you know, the coolest to see.
Absolutely. And The Rock got the biggest ovation of all. And I know that you actually put up a picture of The Rock on your Instagram. I'm sure that got a few likes, huh?
Oh, yeah. It was pretty cool, man. You know, it was a cool experience to see this guy on TV and the movies and then and in the wrestling ring. It was pretty cool to see his character in person. It was awesome. It was a good experience.
Now, he was a character in the ring, but sitting behind us, there was another character. Yeah. I really felt bad for you.
There was a couple of characters.
It was about two-thirds of the way through the show, and you absolutely got drenched in some guy's
beer.
Well, you did,
too. You both did.
Well, not nearly as bad as Pierre. Pierre took a bath in Budweiser.
You did an amazing job of controlling your emotions. How were you able to do that? I was actually very, very impressed because I was getting mad because they were talking about, oh, this big guy in front, I feel like he could eat me. You know, he was talking about me because he was sitting behind me, and I was getting mad, but you got beer spilled on you and you were calmer than I was. How'd you compose yourself so well?
I can't really do what I wanted to do, but a fan enjoying the show. He's excited and he had a few drinks, but it's, you know, it happens. You can't really let things like that get to you. You just got to walk away from the situation and go home.
He had a few lot too many drinks is what he had.
I'll tell you, you know, when he when he walked away down the other side, I guess he was talking to somebody else obnoxiously. I stole the beer that he left on his seat.
You did? He didn't even notice it.
No, he was too drunk to notice that I stole his beer.
Well, him and the security guard were about to go at it. They were about to get in the fisticuffs.
This guy was just a train wreck.
He was almost as entertaining as Raw was, to be honest.
I hope that you're listening, sir. You're a horrible person. That's what you are.
You are a nuisance, my friend.